मिस्टर डेप्यूटी स्पीकर सर, आई राइज टू सपोर्ट द डिमांड्स फॉर ग्रांट्स रिलेटिंग टू द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ लेबर बीइंग हेडेड बाय ए डायनेमिक लीडर एंड यंग मिनिस्टर. इन ए वास्ट कंट्री लाइक आवर्स वेयर वी हैव ए वेरी लार्ज पॉपुलेशन, लेबर फोर्स is a very important ingredient for the development of our nation. This particular human resource has not been utilized to the extent possible. This is indeed regrettable. We should look upon population not only as a liability, but in the given circumstances our population or the manpower should be utilized to the best possible extent by giving suitable training. I think the labor department and the laborers deserve a great deal of respect, because whatever we do in this country, the whole process of national reconstruction revolves around the work of the laborers. In our country, unfortunately, the labor force is not well organized. Only a very small percentage of the labor force, about 10%, is in the organized sector, whereas about 90% of the laborers are in the unorganized sector. About 27 crore laborers are in the unorganized sector and only 3 crore laborers are in the organized sector. For the welfare of a large number of people, various laws are being made. We have been talking about labor legislation for a long time. A lot of legislations have already been made, but we have to consider seriously whether all the legislations have helped the labor class. I am sorry to say that a lot of these laws are just accumulating dust and they have not been really useful in many circumstances. Unless the law is practiced in the proper spirit, the workers will not be benefited. This particular aspect has to be taken into account while making the legislation. Now, there has to be a great deal of political will and enthusiasm to see that the labor laws are really implemented and benefit the people. Our dynamic and young minister has recently said in a meeting in Pune that in this session a new legislation is going to be presented. It may not be completed in this session, but certainly it is going to be introduced, and it is for the benefit of the organized sector. A new comprehensive and integrated legislation is going to be introduced by our government for the sake of guaranteeing minimum wages and for providing pension for people in the unorganized sector. The condition of the laborers is indeed very bad in our country. Look at any factory or any of the big public sector undertakings. How much care does the employer take for the benefit of the laborers, on whose integrity and hard work the whole enterprise of that particular industry is flourishing? You will find that a very few industrialists really look into the different welfare aspects of the laborers. Take the example of families and children of the laborers. डू देयर एम्प्लॉयर्स मेक प्रॉपर अरेंजमेंट फॉर देयर हेल्थ केयर एंड एजुकेशन, लीव असाइड देयर कल्चरल अपलिफ्टमेंट और देयर कल्चरल लाइफ. सच एफर्ट्स आर नॉट मेड इवन इन द ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर. What happens in the unorganized sector is anybody's guess. The families of the laborers are not looked after properly, and a great deal needs to be done, and in this regard, voluntary organizations can play some role. A small amount of 3 lakhs of rupees has been provided for the welfare of children and women in the unorganized sector. I would urge upon the Honorable Minister that the allocations to the voluntary organizations for the betterment of women and children in the organized as well as unorganized sectors should be increased. As regards the lockouts, wherever there is a lockout of the industry, the laborers have a great deal of suffering. They do not know what to do. They are just left to their lot. But the employer does not suffer as much. Just look at the employers of different big industries. Their standard of living does not change after locking the industry, but the people in the factories are left on the street. I suggest that whenever the question of lockout in a particular industry comes up, the question should be considered whether the laborers will be able to run a particular industry, and a lot of consideration should be given to this particular aspect, and if possible, that particular industry should be kept alive. Migration is a very important problem of laborers, and it has got multi dimensions. Laborers within the country and those who are going outside the country. Lot of laborers are exported outside the country, and they are facing lot of problems because of the agencies. I would like to mention here one thing, that we have entrusted this work to many of the private agencies, but there is need to consider whether we can have a manpower corporation and assign this work to the corporation. Also, there are problems of interstate migration of the laborers. There is an act, but it is causing difficulties to the laborers who migrate to other states.